Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, initially we have did the various gas laws, that is Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, and based on that we have got to know what is ideal gas equation, and from that we are now going to talk about what are actually ideal gases. So let us talk about it and let us see what are the deviations that many gases take place from the ideal gas behavior. So as on your screen, ideal gases obeys Boyle's law, Charles' law and ideal gas equation over entire range of pressure and temperature. So the main thing about ideal gas law equation, or we could say that there are ideal gases which obeys Boyle's law and Charles' law, but in actual practice there are no ideal gases that has been available, because it is a very theoretical concept in which they obey Boyle's law, Charles' law, Avogadro's law, and from which ideal gas equation has been derived. But the most important thing is, because ideal gas equation has a relation with the pressure, volume and temperature, so we could say that the ideal gases won't have intermolecular force of attraction with each other, because in actual practice what happens is the gases can have intermolecular force of attraction by which the volume can be decreased, or because of which they won't follow ideal gas equation. So based on that, ideal gas equation are those who have no intermolecular force of attraction between them, and since they have no intermolecular force of attraction between the two molecules of the ideal gases, so that means that those gases cannot be compressed at a particular pressure or temperature or at volume also. So therefore this implies that the ideal gases cannot be liquefied. So this is the ideal gas that we have talking about. So now moving towards the next one, that is the van der Waals forces between the gases molecules which are responsible for liquefaction of gases are not being observed in ideal gas, because as you know that ideal gas have no force of attraction between them. So van der Waals force is a kind of force of attraction that holds the two gas molecules with each other, just like the hydrogen bonding that holds the two molecules with each other if they have the electronegativity difference between them. But van der Waals force is also same like that, so they have force of attraction, but the ideal gas have no van der Waals force of attraction, and the gases who have van der Waals force of attraction and who has capacity to decrease or to get compressed are nothing known as the real gases or non-ideal gases, because ideal gases have something that can't change their volume and they can't be compressed, as well as they obey that law overall all the range of pressure and temperature, but it is not applicable for all the gases. And those gases who do not follow or who naturally gives a force of attraction between the two molecules so as to compress the volumes or so as to get liquefied, they are known as the non-ideal gases or real gases. We are going to talk about it in a very deep detail also, but let us see what are the few statements that I have written here. So it has been said that at high pressure and low temperature, volume of the gases are low. So this is for the real gases, which we say. Suppose if for a real gas, if I have to carry real gas and if I try to pressurize it, or if I try to give more pressure to it, and at the same time, suppose if I reduce the temperature. So what happens is, because of force, because of the excess of the pressure, or if I increase the pressure, then the two gas molecules, they will combine with each other. And if they combine with each other, then there is a possibility that the two will have a kind of van der Waals force of attraction, or kind of will have any force of attraction between them, or intermolecular force of attraction, and because of which they will have a possibility, or they will be having a liquefaction factor which makes the volume reduce, and the volume will be less because the gas molecules will occupy the space between them and they will come close to each other. So this is shown by the real gases. So now, but this is also possible that we could convert any gas to liquefaction if we give a high pressure and low temperature that we have talking about. So because of which the volume will get reduced and they will compress with and yes, they will come together with each other, and the gas can be liquefied. So the gaseous molecules have more intermolecular force and they deviate from ideal behavior. So those gas molecules who get compressed are not showing idle behavior, because idle guys are those who can't be compressed at any pressure or at any temperature. Naturally, yes, there are gases that can be compressed with a limited range of pressure and temperature. So basically that are non-ideal gases, or basically real gases. So let me tell you that how does this gases behave different from that of the ideal gas, which is basically a theoretical concept. So there are few gases which obey, and there are few gases that can be compressible there are few gases that cannot be compressible at high temperature or low pressure. So let us talk about that. So for that instance, I have drawn an example in this case. So as you could see that this is a graph which deals with the pressure volume and the pressure on excesses. As you could see, there is a pressure excess, and which is having a unit of atmosphere, while that of the y-axis is having a unit of liter atmosphere per mole. So in these cases, I have mentioned four gases basically, that is carbon monoxide, methane, H2 gas and HE. So in this case, as you could see that if we consider for an ideal gas, that is ideal gas equation, suppose if I consider that is PV is equal to nRT. So in this case, I could clearly say that the number of moles of the gas will be the constant, the R, that is the gas constant, it will be the same, while the temperature, in this case, the overall temperature is also the same, that is when I'm talking about the graph. So if N and R and T, suppose if these three are constant, that makes the product of pressure and volume, that is P into V, will be the constant value. So therefore this P into V is parallel to the x-axis, which is nothing but the constant. So anything that will obey the gas ideal gas equation will be the ideal gas. So therefore this is the ideal gas, a theoretical ideal gas that we have mentioned here. So it will have a constant value of P into V. So now when talking about at constant temperature, suppose if this all gases are being kept in a constant temperature, that is suppose 0 degree Celsius, if I'm talking, so they are all are kept under a study of 0 degree Celsius. And if we see that at lower pressure, suppose if in this case the pressure is going increasing, while in this case the P into V is going it is been increasing. So at lower pressure means when I'm talking about this region, if you would say, most of the gases originate and they start or to deviate as the pressure goes on increasing. But initially what happens is at lower pressure, all the gases, that is when I'm talking about these four gases, all the gases are acting like ideal gas, because they are originating from this point, and yes, they are behaving like ideal gas. But what happens if I increase the pressure? When I'm talking about, suppose I'm talking about the gases like H2 and helium. Suppose if I increase the pressure, then I could see that the value of P into V also increases, and it goes on increasing, and yes, it is deviating from the ideal gas. They should have been parallel with the ideal gases, but they are not actually. So they are deviating from the ideal gases, which makes them that they are basically the real gases. And one more thing talking about is that when it comes to that pressure into volume graph, if you would see, then the value increases as the pressure goes on increasing. This makes that the volume, that is pressure into volume, they will have more value, and because of which these two gases are not compressible. They won't be compressing each other, because the volume, pressure into volume, this value goes on increasing. And if the volume, suppose it goes on increasing, then it is very less possible for a particular gas to get compressed. Now talking about the next one, that is this where the two things about helium and hydrogen, talking about the gases like carbon monoxide and CH4, that is methane. So initially if we will see that till this much pressure, what happens is if we increase the pressure, the value of P into V goes on decreasing, that is for both CH4, as you could see this graph, and for the CO, that as we could see. So they are being deviating from the ideal gas, but yes, they are deviating lower wise. So they are deviating lower wise, as we could see. So this makes the value of P into V go on decreasing with increasing pressure. This makes the volume to go decrease, because what happens is the volume of the gases will compress with each other, means it will go on decreasing. The gases will come combine with each other, and the volume will get reduced. And if the volume will get reduced, what happens is there is a chances, or there is a possibility of the gases molecules to combine with each other or to liquefy with each other. So it is applicable for that is carbon monoxide and CH4, but up till a limit range only, that is at lower pressure. So when we give more pressure, that is when we give high pressure to that, and if the pressure goes on increasing, we could clearly see that this graph also goes on increasing. And yes, there is a value where we could see that the value of P into V is more compared to that of when we compare it with the pressure and when we compare it with other gases. So this CO value has also more P into V value, which makes that these two gases are also not compressible at high pressure. So they are basically liquefiable up till a limited pressure, that is they are liquefiable till here only. So therefore, there are two kinds of deviation that we would see, that is the positive deviations, that is H2 and HE. They are always positive, they show positive deviation, which makes them that they are not easily compressible, they won't be easily compressible if we apply more pressure to that. And we are talking about 0 degree Celsius, so the temperature is here because it is 0 degree Celsius, we are talking about the temperature. So now, talking about the positive has been done. Now when we are talking about the negative deviation, so here we could see the negative deviations, and this negative deviations are shown by carbon monoxide and methane gases. So this makes them to get liquefied, and yes, they are, and that's why they are showing a negative deviation. So this gases, the all the gases that we have mentioned, they are behaving ideal gases, but up till a limit range, that is up to a limit range of pressure, and a temperature is also been fixed for all those. But yes, they are not said to be ideal gases overall, because if the pressure increases, they deviate from the ideal gases and they don't behave like ideal gas. So this was it. So talking about the compressibility, yes, it comes to and carbon monoxide and CH4, this, yes, these two gases can be compressible easily compared to that of the other one at a particular pressure. So that's what it and what I was going to explain, and this is the deviation of the some gases which are away from that of the ideal gases. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very much clearly, and you will try to do more reading on this, and yes, you will gain more knowledge on that too. So share this video with your friends, and yes, please don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.